on political trend, and there is no better person to succeed you as a representative of Ukraine, who is clearly going through an election at the moment, where the lead incumbent is actually, well, I'll leave it to you to characterize who he is. I won't say, but it might be an illustration of what John is saying. So.
Thank you, Christian. I think if we are looking at the trends, obviously there are a number of changing realities that we have to face. I would like to focus on the three which I think have the global impact, but we can clearly see it in Ukraine as well. The first one is migration. And when we say about migration, it's not only the migration of people, even though migration of people has become, I think, the key opportunity, but also the key problem for a number of nations, and we see it in Ukraine with a lot of people migrating to Poland and to other countries. It's migration of capital and specifically the migration of profits. We also see it in Ukraine, and we see the need of new joint efforts if we want to develop and create values in our countries and also tax them property in our countries. But also continue the cooperation. It's the migration of problems as well. There has been problems which were country specifics before, but we now see that a number of problems are becoming the problems that we export to each other because our economies and our political systems are becoming very interrelated. The second big trend is the continuing digital technological disruption, innovation, and specifically the open data. Which again is a big source of innovation and a big source of new development, and it has been in Ukraine. Ukraine been developing the fintech, the agri-tech, and been at the forefront. But it also poses a lot of new questions which we need to answer. Do we protect the data sufficiently? Do we protect our systems from manipulations from either inside or from within? And we saw it in a number of elections, not only in Ukraine, but in other countries. And more importantly, I think, is we have to think about the future, about our children, who now get access to large data, large information, even before they develop the critical thinking tools. Are they prepared to process this data correctly and make the decisions that they will be making in 10, 15, 20 years at the next elections? And that leads me to the third trend, which I see everywhere, but also in Ukraine, is the rise of populism. And this anti-establishment sentiment, which we see in politics, but not only in politics. And how do we as leaders or technocrats or managers or political leaders, how do we cope with it and how do we still lead the change and how do we still push for the necessary reforms in the situation when our citizens demand the fast food solutions, they want them yesterday, and they are ready for the change sometimes without analyzing truly whether this change will bring what they are truly looking for. So I think these three combined is, shaping the new reality in which we have to find the new solution. We have to embrace this change in order to find the solution for this new reality.